China says it will continue to negotiate until the last minute on the European Union's electric vehicle probe. China's Commerce Minister Wang Wentao made that statement before a gathering of 30 top executives of Chinese and European EV industries. They are meeting to discuss views on the EU's anti-subsidy case against China EVs. Now, the European Commission is on the verge of proposing final tariffs of up to 35.3% on EVs built in China. The 27-member bloc will vote on the final duties on September 25 before implementing them by the end of October.
Dismissed Mamban Mayor Alice Go facing the House Quad Committee for the first time. The panel is investigating illegal drugs, POGOs, and the alleged Duterte-era extrajudicial killings. The former mayor claims she delisted from Baofu Corporation around a week before she filed her candidacy for Bamban Mayor. She denies any further involvement in Baofu or the other two companies operating the massive illegal POGO in her town.
There are speculations, Ms. Alice, na itong Hong Sheng, ang Baofu, Zun Yuan, and you are one and the same. Do you agree?
Totally not agree.
September 16, 2020, you signed the application in the Sangguniang Bayan of Bamban in behalf of Hong Sheng, applying for franchise, license, and permit.
Your Honor, I did not sign any documents po. However, nakalagay po yung pangalan ko po dyan as representative, but I did not sign any documents po.
Would you know kung sino ang naglagay ng pangalan mo?
Your Honor, I have no idea.
In the campaign against illegal drugs, as mayor...
Also present at the hearing, former Iloilo Mayor Jed Mabilog. Mabilog surrendered to Philippine authorities last week after his seven-year self-exile in the U.S. He fled the country in 2017 after then-President Rodrigo Duterte tagged him as an alleged narco-politician. The former mayor firmly denied this in his speech during the inquiry.
Bigla na lamang na isama ang mga pangalan sa PRRD narco list ng Administrasyong Duterte. Isang listahan naglalaman ng mga pangalan ng mga kilalang public official na di umano ay sangkot sa ilegal na droga, mga paratang na walang basihan, at kahit kailan ay hindi naman napatunayan. On August 28, 2017, I received an unexpected call from former PNP Regional Director Bernardo Diaz. He invited me to meet with PNP Chief Ronald De La Rosa, now Senator, at Camp Crame, Quezon City, at noon the following day. The next morning, on August 29, I arrived at the Ninoy Aquino International Airport at 10 a.m., ready to proceed. But then the call started. First, they moved the meeting to 3 p.m., and then by 5 p.m., it was delayed again, this time to 6 p.m. At around 5 p.m., a PNP colonel called me and, in a voice that sent shivers down my spine, literal po yun, warned me not to go to Camp Crame because my life was in danger. The fear that had been simmering now erupted. Soon after, at 6:32 p.m., my wife, Marivic, received a chilling text from a PNP colonel's wife, "Do not proceed. There are 20 men surrounding your house, and if you go to Camp Crame, they will kill you." The terror was paralyzing. I couldn't believe it. I was not and never will be a drug protector. I don't know personally, nor did I benefit in any way from any illegal drug personality in Iloilo or anywhere else.
The panel will also invite the son of the former president, Davao Representative Paulo Duterte, in the next hearing after he sent a letter to the House expressing intent to raise questions to the resource persons. Former Budget Undersecretary Lloyd Christopher Lau has been released on bail following a brief detention. Lau was arrested Wednesday in Davao City, but he walked free shortly after posting a 90,000 peso bail. Lau was implicated in the anomalous procurement of medical supplies from Farmily Pharmaceutical Corporation at the height of the COVID-19 pandemic. He and former Health Secretary Francisco Duque were charged with graft. But former Senator Richard Gordon, who led the Blue Ribbon Committee investigation into the Farmily scandal, is insisting plunder charges should be filed, which is non-bailable.
Eleven billion ang ninako niya mga yan. And then they get a bail of 90,000. And what about the others? What about Secretary Duque? What about yung mga Indians, sila Dargani? And what about Michael Young? You have all the evidence. Airtight yung kaso kung gagamitin yan. Because from the very moment that we investigated it, you just asked the question, who appointed Lau? Who appointed Leong? All right? And in spite of their cases, who transferred the money? Who ordered the transfer of the money? Who said it's all right not to bid? Who was haranguing COA for investigating Farmily and all these guys? Who was haranguing us in the Blue Ribbon? President Duterte.
Philippine authorities validating 23 reported deaths due to the southwest monsoon and the three consecutive tropical cyclones. The country's disaster officials say 23 others were left injured, while 15 more remain missing. The bad weather also affected nearly 300,000 families, 18,000 of whom were forced to flee their homes. The southwest monsoon, enhanced by storms Ferdy, Henner, and Helen, damaged over 1,200 houses. The NDRRMC estimates the cost of damage to infrastructure due to the bad weather was at 2.4 million pesos.